data, then we perform some, we can perform some feature pre-processing. Then okay, next point is that feature, then EDA we have performed through the visualization. Then we can perform the feature reduction. Suppose your data is high dimensional, anyway this data is not high dimensional, but suppose your data is the high dimensional, then you can perform the feature reduction method. So broadly we can categorize this feature reduction method into the category feature selections and feature extraction. In the feature selections, we preserve the original features and we will choose the relevant features. So as I told, we try to ignore the irrelevant features. Irrelevant features means those features which have not good discrimination ability. Similarly, for the redundant features, means suppose you have two features which are highly correlated, so we will select only one. Then in the feature extraction, as we discussed the PCA, so in the PCA we transform the original features into the new feature space. Then we will get some principal component, and based on the requirement, based on the threshold, we will choose the principal component. Now feature selections we will further categorize in the filter method and the wrapper methods. So in the filter method, basically we let us discuss here the filter method. So in the filter method, basically what we will do, we based on based on any particular parameters, we try to rank the features. So here in the unsupervised ranking case, means unsupervised means that the class information of the data point are not known. So here we can use one parameter, which is the variance. So variance score you can use to rank the features, means higher the variance, better features will be. So here, as you know the formula for this variance here, so you can just apply this and you can get this variance. Now also you know aware about the information gain. So information gain ranking means this is applied for the supervised ranking method. If you have class label in your data set, then you can able to apply this information gain. Means higher the information gain, better features will be. So in this way you can rank the features, and then you have to select the subset of the features, and then you have to give to the machine learning model. Now removing the redundant features, Pearson correlation coefficient you can use for that, as we saw. Now what is difference between the filter method and wrapper method? So basically what happened in the filter method, first based on the ranking we select the subset of the features, then we give to the machine learning model. For example, any unsupervised or supervised machine learning model, then based on those selected subset of the feature, we find the performance of the machine learning model. Now in the wrapper method, we have some complex method. In the complex method, what basically we do, we choose the subset of the features, maybe through the particular procedure like the feature forward selection, feature forward backward selection, or maybe the randomly. Based on your search method, you will select the subset of the feature. So as you know, in the optimization, in the machine learning, optimization is the heart of machine learning algorithm. Hence, to search the features, you have to apply optimization method. So here you can apply the feature forward or backward or random. So whenever you select any particular subset based on any criteria, then you have to check through the machine learning model. So machine learning model produce particular performance. Then again you have to choose another subset, again you have to give to the machine learning algorithm. If your performance is better, then you will choose the new one. Otherwise, you will continue with the old one. So in this way, you can perform the wrapper method. In the feature forward selection and backward selection, there is how you will apply this feature forward selection for the wrapper method. Suppose you have ranked the features. Then based on the ranking, first we will take the first features, then we will apply the machine learning model. So machine learning model suppose give the 30% accuracy, then we will add the second ranked features, then it is the 32%. Machine learning algorithm accuracy is 32%. Then we will choose the second one. Suppose we have selected the third one, but it is accuracy is decreasing. In that case, we will ignore the third feature. We will go for the fourth feature. So we will continue this process till the end. We will process the all the features. So how it works, you can see through this example. This is a very simple example. We try to, suppose you have the objective function, this one. Okay, so objective function, suppose you have objective function for the any particular machine learning model, you just assume it. Then based on that, you have to select the feature. So we have four features here, X1, X2, X3, X4. So four features are there. The criteria is that if you select any particular features, so this will be considered as one. And if you ignore that feature, so it will be considered as zero. So this objective functions, you just now how you will apply the feature forward selection. So you select the single features. So here the single features I have selected X1. So if you put means the rest X2, X3 and X4 will be zero and X1 will be one. So if you put all these value in this equation, you will get the JX1 equal to 3. Similarly, if you say you want to select the X2 features, then this X2 features you have to keep one, rest X1, X3 and X4 you have to keep zero. Then you will get 5. Similarly, for X3, you will get 7 and 4. So this is the maximization problem, you can say. You just assume. So here, ZX3 is giving highest value out of these four. So you have to explore this part. So means you have selected one feature, which is the X3. Now you want to go for the next features. So here, rest of the features are X1. X2 and X4. Now, whenever you add X1, so it is giving 10. Then if you add X2 with X3, so it is giving 12. Now, if you are adding X4 with X3, then it is giving 11. So second feature you want try to add with X3, because X3 you have already selected. So here you can observe that out of 10, 12 and 11, 12 is the highest. So we will explore this node. Then already you have selected X3 and X2. Then we will go for the rest of the features. So rest of the features are X1 and X4. So we will add X1. So we are getting 11. Similarly, we will getting 16. So here 16 is higher than the 11, so we will explore this X3, X2 and X4, means already we have selected three features. Now only one feature is remaining, X1. Then whenever we include X1, here we can observe that this objective function value is decreased. So we will ignore the feature X1. So these are the relevant features in this process. So this is the procedure where we can apply the feature forward selection using the wrapper method. Means we will select the features, then we will check every time what is the classification accuracy for the particular model. Okay, so based on that we will choose the features. Then okay, so let us discuss the principal component analysis through one example, because this is also very important. So here we have four major steps for this particular principal component analysis. First one is the standardize the data set, calculate the covariance matrix for the features in the data set. Fifth third is the calculate the eigenvalues and vector for the covariance matrix, and sort eigenvalues and their corresponding eigenvectors, and pick k eigenvalues and form a matrix of eigenvectors. So let us discuss this PCA. This is very important. So here we will transform the features into the new features space. So we have different steps to perform all these PCA. Here, just take a data set. I have not taken that red wine data set. I try to explain through the other example, otherwise it will be very complex, because the mathematical calculation for the PCA is very complex. So let us take a very small data set which is containing only four features. So this is the unsupervised feature reduction methods, because here we are not using any particular class label. Now first step, standardize the data set. So here we are convert into this feature space into the new matrix. So how you will convert into the new matrix? So this is the formula, x minus mu divided by lambda. So mu is the average value for all the data points. So here the for F1, you can say the average for this 1, 5, 1, 5 and 8 is the 4. Now, if you calculate the variance through this formula, you will get the 3. Now you put the value here. So this is the first value, 1. So 1 minus mu means 4 divided by 3. So you will get minus 1. So in this way, you will transform this matrix into the new matrix. So this is the first step for the PCA. Now calculate the covariance matrix for the whole data set. So you have to calculate the covariance matrix. As you know, the formula for this covariance matrix is this one. So here you have to perform the, you have to evaluate the covariance matrix. So based on that, you will get this matrix. You calculate, you will get this matrix. Then now calculate the eigenvector and eigenvalues. First of all, you have to calculate the eigenvalues. So an eigenvector is the non-zero vector that changes at most by a scalar factor when that linear transformation is applied to it. The corresponding eigenvalue is the factor by which the eigenvector is scaled. So here, let us consider A be the square matrix. Whatever the matrix, covariance matrix we got, that consider as a A. And V are vector and lambda are scalar that satisfied this condition. So you have to choose V and lambda that satisfy this condition. Okay, so lambda is the called eigenvalue associated with the eigenvector V of A. So lambda is called the eigenvalue. So we try to calculate this eigenvalue accordingly. We will calculate this eigenvector V. So you try to you just rearrange this equation, then you will get this one, AV minus lambda V equal to 0, then you will get this equation. So as you know, AV and minus lambda V will be equal to 0 if their determinant will be 0. So so based on that, you will get, you will calculate this, you will solve this matrix, and finally you will get this value of the lambda. So as we have four features, so you will get the four value for the lambda. So this is the these are the eigenvalue. So here you can observe that the first eigenvalue is very high with respect to these two. Similarly, second one is also considerably high with respect to the third and fourth one. So you can observe that these first and second are really a significant component. So based on these, eigenvalues, you can calculate the eigenvectors here. So I have taken the first one. Based on this first one, we evaluated this vector, v1, v2, v3, and v4. So you will get the eigenvector corresponding to this lambda, first eigenvalues, which is very highly significant in the transform feature space. So this is the first transform features, means eigenvector. So accordingly, if you apply for all eigenvalues, you will get this vector. So as you know, these two are the highly significant. So you have to choose these two features, and based on that, you have to go for the machine learning model. So in this way, you can select the highly significant component transformed. It is not the original features, vectors. These are the transform features. So based on the their eigenvalues, you can select the eigenvector. So these are the significant component, principal component. Now, so far we have all these pre-processing. So I try to do through the Python, but because of the technical issue, I am not able to directly see this directly show through the Python, but I convert it into the PPT form. So you can observe here. Here I try to find the variance for the red wine data set. Okay, so if you need the code, you can mail me. I will send this code. And here you can observe that we are getting the variance for all the 11 features. So you can here observe that sulfur is having highest value, highest variance. Second highest is free sulfur dioxide. This is the 109 here. Then third one is, you can hear, fixed acidity is 3.0 something. Okay, so you can see that this one and this one, and these are very significant features, as we also observe in the visual way in that EDA. We can apply based on that ranking. So we can rank those features. So based on the ranking, you can apply, if you want, you can apply the feature forward selection. So let us see here. We try to perform the feature forward selection. So first of all, we have taken alcohol. So here, the accuracy for F1 score is 0.56. Then we included the second feature, volatile acidity. Then your accuracy is 0.59, means it is increasing. Now again we added the citric acid, then it is increasing again, so 0.60. similarly, we have taken the another one, fluoride. So it is not significantly contributing. So in that case, we will not take these features. Similarly, here you can observe that whenever we add the sulfate, so here the performance is decreasing, 0.5968. Earlier it was the 0.60 something. So here we will ignore these features. So if performance is not increasing or decreasing, in that case we will not include the features. So in this way, we will find the set of relevant features through the feature forward selections. So now we have also performed the information gain. Then based on the information gain, here you can see the result. Here for the feature number 8, we are getting highest information gain, 0.75. Similarly, for the second features, we are getting 0.39 information gain, which is the second highest. And for the third one, this 11th is the third position. Similarly, seventh features is on fourth position. So in this way, you can find the information gain and you can choose the relevant features. But important part is that here it is required the class label. In the ranking method using the variance, we don't require adding class label. In the PCA, we have different approach, but we don't require any class label. But here in the information gain, we require the class label. Now we applied the PCA and we perform each and we generated the covariance matrix. So in this way, here we observed that we have two main component. Here we got the two main component. It is not properly visible, so just ignore it. So we got the two principal component here, and based on that we find the accuracy. Then we are getting the accuracy for individual class level. You can observe here the precision recall and F1 score for every features. Finally, we get the accuracy for the all the class is 0.54 using two principal component in the PCA, and we have applied the logistic regression for this one. So here you can see that we have applied the logistic regression classifier to perform this operation. So we will also discuss the logistic regression. Okay, so theoretically, the thing is that so far we have covered the very important task, which is very time consuming. So pre-processing, EDA, and feature means you have, if you want to refine your data, it is most of the time 80% time is consumed by these process. So these steps are very important. If you want to go for the machine learning, and if you apply all these things for the beginner, you can use these sites. Okay, if you want to work on the advanced level, you have to refer the Kaggle, because you have the many notebook available there. And if you have a very complex and real data set, in now so far define R, which is in the row form, and we try to convert into the structure form, then we will able to give into the machine learning model. Now if you have class level, then you can go for the, you have to go for the unsupervised machine learning. Similarly, other machine learning model, we have reinforcement learning, so it work on the reward and punishment. So I think it is already covered in your FTP. Then deep learning, it is something based on the neural network, deep neural network. So here, this as you know, this artificial intelligence mainly experience. So how this machine learning get experience from the data, and that try to refine the model based on the experience of data. So now you can broadly categorize this machine learning. So here we will take the one logistic regression as a classifier in the supervised machine learning, but regression is also the part of the supervised machine. So here, what is the major difference between this regression and classification? In the regression, we have continuous output. In the classification, we have discrete output. As we discuss in require thing other information. Here we don't have any class information, so here we will perform the clustering. Now later, so here we have already taken one data set red wine. So we have several use cases for this supervised machine learning as a classification. So you can deal with the many use cases as per your choice. So use cases may be the like that a particular leader will be win the election or not, this kind of the based on the training data set you can train the model and you get this kind of the you can get this kind of the decision from this machine learning model. Similarly, you can see whether the student will pass or fail. So what basically happens this particular case. So similarly we have many use cases. Now very common supervised methods here as a so in the your email you can you observe that your email may be classified as the primary, social, promotional. So behind of this classification we have the machine learning model which pre-process the text data and we then based on the giving the training to through that pre-processed data and we try means that machine learning model which is working behind the scene try to recognize your the new email is in primary category or social category or etc. Okay, now let's